I'm Bud Johnson, reading Jeremiah 11, 1 through 8. The word of the Lord came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Hear the words of this covenant and speak to the people of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem. You shall say to them, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, cursed be anyone who does not heed the words of this covenant, which I commanded your ancestors when I brought them out of the land of Egypt, from the iron smelter, saying, listen to my voice and do all that I command you. So shall you be my people, and I will be your God, that I may perform the oath that I swore to your ancestors to give them the land flowing with milk and honey. And as at this day, then I answered, so be it, Lord. The Lord said to me, proclaim all these words in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem. Hear the words of this covenant and do them. For I solemnly warned your ancestors when I brought them up out of the land of Egypt, warning them persistently, even to this day, saying, obey my voice. Yet they did not obey or incline their ear, but everyone walked in stubbornness of an evil will. So I brought upon them all of the words of this covenant, which I commanded them to do, but they did not. The reflection. Covenant is different from a contract. While a contract is more binding and legalistic, a covenant creates space and room for one to change their heart. In a covenant, there is a possibility for growth, whereby one returns to the covenantal relationship. In this covenant relationship between God and the ancient Israel, God gives Jeremiah a message for Judah and Jerusalem to keep. God's covenant is a continually seek God's forgiveness when we fall, and so to recommit to our covenantal relationship with God. Now we'll pause for questions for the reflection. What are some covenant relationships you have with family, members, or friends? What do you do to nurture your covenantal relationship with God? Join me in the word of prayer. Dear covenantal and sovereign God, we are blessed because of your grace and mercy, without which our covenantal relationship with you will be impossible. Grant that we may extend this gracious and covenantal relationship to others, especially our neighbors, close, and those far away. Amen.
Hi, this is Mary, and I am going to be singing hymn number 140, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Great is Thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast been, Thou forever wilt be. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have need, Thy hand hath provided. Great